Hi everyone, it's Hiro. Today, I'm going to talk about one of the body shape variations in Medaka, called the Hikari body type. We'll dive into its unique features and genetics. You might think Medaka are just small, plain fish, but no way. Japanese Medaka have an incredible range of varieties, and I truly believe they have the potential to go global. In Japan, Medaka are already a huge craze. So if you want to be a share of the trend and learn more about them, be sure hit that subscribe button. On this channel, I, Hiro, a Japanese Medaka enthusiast and aquarist, share everything I know about Japanese aquariums and fish with people around the world. I'm still learning English, but I do my best to share accurate info about Medaka. I've added English subtitles too, so feel free to use them while watching. Alright, let's get started. What is the Hikari body type? Let me start by explaining what the Hikari body type actually is. Take a look at this image. This is a Medaka with a Hikari body type. Now compare it to a regular shaped Medaka, the one that looks like your typical fish. You can clearly see that the Hikari body type looks not so typical, right? This unique shape comes from a gene called double anal. As the name suggests, the dorsal fin and the anal fin are shaped the same, almost like mirror images across the body's center line. Not only that, the tail fin also changes into a rhomb shape. The pectoral and pelvic fin stay the same as in regular Medaka. Now, the word Hikari in Japanese means light or shine. This name was given because the shiny, iridescent color you usually see on the belly also appear on the back, thanks to this special body structure. Here is what it looks like from above. Medaka naturally have iridescent pigments on their bellies, and Hikari body types, the shine can appear on their backs as well. However, not all Hikari Medaka actually shine. Some strains, like those with black limb scales, don't have much of that iridescent on their bellies. So when you look at them from above, they look more plain in color. Still, even if they don't shine, the dorsal and anal fins are symmetrical, and the tail is diamond-shaped, so they are still classified as Hikari body type. Was that a big match to take it at once? Don't worry. There are many different kinds of Hikari Medaka, so it's very helpful to start by understanding these basic traits. Let's talk about Hikari genetics. Alright, from here on, things might get a little tricky. We are diving into the genetics behind the Hikari body type. First, it's known that the gene for the Hikari body shape follows a pattern called incomplete dominance. Let me give you a classic example using the morning glory flower. Let's say there is a gene capital A that produces red petals, and a gene a lowercase a that give you a white petals. According to Mendel's law of dominance, if you cross a double capital A flower with a lowercase double A flower, you'd expect all the offspring to be capital A and lowercase A, and they'd all have red petals, because red is dominant. But in incomplete dominance, things work a little differently. Instead of showing just a dominant trait, the offspring shows a blend of the two. So in this case, the capital A and lowercase a flowers would have pink petals, right between red and white. And guess what? This same rule of incomplete dominance also seems to apply to the Hikari body type in Medaka. But there's one twist. The Hikari trait itself is recessive. So, if you cross a regular body type Medaka with a Hikari body type Medaka, you'll get offspring that look like this. Can you spot what's different? The answer? It's a number of rays in the dorsal fin. In a regular Medaka, a dorsal fin usually has about 6 rays. But when one parent had the Hikari body type, the offspring can show an increased number of rays, around 10. It's just like a pink flower example earlier. You don't get the full Hikari body shape, but the extra rays in the dorsal fin hint that the gene is definitely there. And here is the cool part. If you take that 10 rays Medaka and breed it again with the Hikari body type, you can get actual Hikari body shaped Medaka in the next generation. If you breed two Hikari body type Medaka together, of course, you'll get more Hikari offspring. However, there is a catch. The Hikari body shape tends to be affected by another gene that can cause the spine to curve. Yep, I bred Hikari Medaka myself, and sometimes I ended up with fish that are very wavy, bent backs like this. So, if you're aiming to breed clean, well-shaped fish, it might actually help to mix in regular body type Medaka from time to time. It's a way to reset the body shape and correct structural issues. But honestly, when you look at them from above, you don't even notice the curved back. If you're just keeping them as pets, no problem at all. Just love them the way they are. That said, if you are aiming for competitions or want to keep your Medaka looking perfect, this genetic stuff becomes super important. So I hope today's info helps. I think this kind of attention to details and selective breeding really shows something special about Japanese craftsmanship and culture. And that wraps up our talk on the Hikari body type. Thanks so much for watching. If you enjoyed this video or learning something new, give it a thumbs up and leave a comment. I'd love to hear your thoughts. Don't forget to subscribe for more Medaka tips and Japanese aquarium content. I'll see you again in the next video. Until then, happy fish keeping!